King Tutankhamun, Tutankhamun, or simply King Tut, ruled Egypt as pharaoh for 10 years until his death at age 19, around 1324 before Christ, though his rule was notable for reversing the religious reforms of his father Akhenaten, Tutankhamun's legacy was largely negated by his successors. He was barely known to the modern world until 1922, when British archaeologist Howard Carter chipped into the intact tomb of King Tut. The tomb's hoard of treasure, intended to accompany the king into the afterlife, revealed an incredible amount about life in ancient Egypt and made Tutankhamun the world's most famous pharaoh. This was stated by Major General Engineer Atef Moftah, the general supervisor of the Grand Egyptian Museum project, noting that the transfer process was reviewed through the Tourism and Antiquities projects. Dr. Altayeb Abbas, Assistant Minister of Tourism and Antiquities for Archaeological Affairs at the Grand Egyptian Museum, explained that this cabin is the largest of the entire collection of King Tutankhamun, which is gilded wood. It was found in addition to three other chapels within the king's holdings in his tomb on the western bank of Luxor, and it was displayed in gallery of pictures shown on it in November 1922. Presents Dr. Altayeb Abbas the area, the exhibition space, an area of 7,200 square meters and equipped with the latest means of museum display from two vatters with environmental control of temperature, humidity, and lighting, in addition to the graph of the list and the display of lines for your scheduler, as well as the work of placing other artifacts of the King Tutankhamun, is 95% finished according to its schedule. For his part, Mr. Momin Othman, head of the Al-Waf sector at the Supreme Council of Antiquities, said that the process of transferring part of the department to the exact principles and standards followed in part, partly inside an internal fund and another internal, and the house is not affected by the layers of gilding in all the walls of the cabin. The reference indicates that the process of transferring the transfers of the first parts of King Tutankhamun is one of the most important transfers and installations in the world, in which the Egyptian restorer proved his ingenuity in organic restoration work. The work team included a distinguished group of restorers at the Grand Museum and the Egyptian Museum in Tahrir.